You do maintenance for your car on a regular basis. I'm here doing that for my car right now. How often do you do ongoing maintenance for yourself and for your team, for your organization? What is involved in an organization? It's about building your skills, about getting more effective at what you're doing. The best leaders I know are the ones who are always looking for something more that they can learn. What else can they discover? How can they become better at what they're doing? The ones who think they know it all are the ones who have all the problems. Okay, on a personal level, there's many forms of self-renewal. You have to keep yourself physically in shape, socially, emotionally, spiritually. There's many ways that you can enhance what you're doing. When on a physical level, it's really, really critical to find out what it is that you love to do. What is it that nourishes you to go out and find what you enjoy doing? No one should have to go work hard at exercise. It should be something that you absolutely love doing. For me, it's salsa dancing. What is it for you? Invest the time that you need to get out there. Physical activity keeps you mentally sharper, improves alertness, and it makes you healthier. Now, another piece of this is life-work balance. The interesting thing that's been shown is that people who take more than 10 vacation days a year have double the chance of a raise or promotion compared to those who only take a few days or less than 10. Now, if you're working hard because you think you're invaluable and you're not taking vacation days, all you're doing is destroying your body and you're actually hurting your career. So if you want to be a martyr, rock and roll. If not, there are other ways to look at it. Now, another aspect of self-maintenance is mindfulness. What's interesting here with mindfulness, it's been shown to reduce cortisol levels, to make you far, far more creative, to improve innovation, to enhance your well-being, your engagement at work, productivity, job satisfaction, all of these things that make life worthwhile. Now, you need to do your self-maintenance a lot more often than your car. You can't do it just once a quarter. You have to do it weekly, daily. And you have to invest that time to get the return. I find that when I'm in shape, I actually need an hour less sleep than when I'm not. So I automatically recover any time I spend daily on exercise or meditation and so on. Also, these sort of things, they better be the first things that go in your calendar and the last things that get canceled. What people often do is the reverse. Now, I think of when I was getting married. When I was married, the month before, of course, it was absolutely crazy. We had a billion things to do. But what did we do? I put aside one of those month-at-a-time calendars, and I took the time to say, okay, first, I sat down with my then-fiancé, and I said, what are things that we need to do? Dates for you and me, dates for me and her two sons, and other things that we really need to do to nourish us. We put those in first. And you know what happened? Everything else on our list fit. So what are the things you need to put into your schedule first? You want to take your life from meh to yeah? You better start investing in yourself and in your organization.